All aboard! All aboard! Wow, this is so exciting. Look at everybody who's here tonight. Are you ready to listen to the Polar Express? Oh. Come on up and have a seat. All aboard! All right, let's get started. On Christmas Eve, many years ago, I lay quietly in my bed. I did not rustle the sheets. I breathed slowly and silently. I was listening for a sound a friend had told me I'd never hear, the ringing of the bells of Santa's sleigh. There is no Santa, my friend had insisted, but I knew he was wrong. Late that night, I did hear sounds, though not of ringing bells. From outside came the sounds of hissing steam and squeaking metal. I looked through my window and saw a train standing perfectly still in front of my house. Look at that, looking out the window and seeing a train standing perfectly still in front of the house. It was wrapped in an apron of steam. Snowflakes fell lightly around it. A conductor stood at the open door and one of the cars. He took a large pocket watch from his pocket, and he looked up at my window. I put on my slippers and robe, and I tiptoed downstairs and out the door. All aboard! The conductor cried. I ran up to him. He said, "Well, are you coming?" "Where?" I asked. "Why, to the North Pole, of course. This is the Polar Express." I took his outstretched hand and he pulled me on board. And that's the Polar Express right there. Back there. The train was filled with other children, all in their pajamas and nightgowns. Thank you. We sang Christmas carols and we ate candies with nougat centers as white as snow. We drank hot chocolate, cocoa as thick and rich as melted chocolate bars. I think there may be some chocolate bars here. Oh, look. Wow, just like on the train. Thank you for getting on the train and having chocolate bars. Outside, the lights of towns and villages flickered in the distance as the Polar Express raced northward. Soon, there were no more lights to be seen. We traveled through cold, dark forests. That's a cold, dark forest. See that one? Yes. Where there were lean wolves roaming and white-tailed rabbits hiding from the train as it thundered through the quiet wilderness. We climbed mountains so high, it seemed as if we would scrape the moon. But the Polar Express never slowed down. Faster and faster we ran along, rolling over peaks and through valleys like a car on a roller coaster. The mountains turned into hills. And look at all the snow there on the bridges. We crossed a barren desert of ice, the Great Polar Ice Cap. Have you heard of the Great Polar Ice Cap? Well, now you have. Lights appeared in the distance. They look like lights of a strange ocean liner sailing on a frozen sea. "There," the conductor said, "there is the North Pole." The North Pole, it was a huge city standing alone on the top of the world, filled with factories where every Christmas toy was made. At first, we saw no elves. No elves. The gathering at the center of the city, the conductor told us, that is where Santa will give the first gift of Christmas. Who receives the first gift, we all asked. The conductor answered, he will choose one of you. True. Look, shouted one of the children, the elves. Outside we saw hundreds of elves. As our train drew closer to the center of the North Pole, we slowed to a crawl. So crowded were the streets with Santa's helpers. When the Polar Express could go no further, we stopped and the conductor led us outside. There they are all standing outside, waiting for someone who's... Ooh, who is that? We pressed through the crowd to the edge of a large open circle, and in front of us stood Santa's sleigh. The reindeer were excited. They pranced and paced, ringing the silver sleigh bells that hung from their harnesses. It was a magical sound like nothing I've ever heard. Across the circle, the elves moved apart, and Santa Claus appeared. The elves cheered wildly. He marched over to us and, pointing at me, said, "Let's have this fellow here." He jumped into his sleigh and the conductor handed me up. I sat on Santa's knee and he asked, "Now, God bless you, what would you like for Christmas?" I knew I could have any gift that I could imagine. But the thing I wanted most for Christmas was not inside Santa's giant bag. What I wanted more than anything else was one of the silver bells from Santa's sleigh. When I asked, Santa smiled. Then he gave me a hug and told an elf to cut a bell from a reindeer's harness. The elf tossed it up to Santa. He stood holding the bell high above him and he called out, "The first gift of Christmas!" A clock struck midnight as the elves roared their approval. Santa handed the bell to me and I put it in my bathrobe pocket. The conductor helped me down from the sleigh and shouted out the reindeer's names and cracked the whip. His team charged forward and climbed into the air, and Santa circled once above us like that, and then he disappeared into the night sky. As soon as we were back inside the Polar Express, the other children asked to see the bell. I reached in my pocket, but the only thing I felt was a hole. I had lost the silver bell from Santa's sleigh. "Let's hurry outside and look for it," one of the children said, but the train gave a sudden lurch and started moving. We were on our way home. It broke my heart to lose the bell. When the train reached my house, I sadly left the other children. I stood at my doorway and I waved goodbye. The conductor said something from the moving train, but I couldn't hear him. "What?" I yelled out. He cupped his hands around his mouth. "Merry Christmas!" he shouted. The Polar Express let out a loud blast from its whistle and sped away. On Christmas morning, my little sister Sarah and I opened our presents, and when it looked as if everything had been unwrapped, Sarah found one last small box behind the tree. It had my name on it. Inside was the silver bell. There was a note. "Found this on the seat of my sleigh. Fix that hole in your pocket." Signed, Mr. C. I shook the bell. It made the most beautiful sound my sister and I had ever heard. But my mother said, "Oh, that's too bad." And my father said, it's broken. When I'd shaken the bell, my parents heard not a sound. At one time, most of my friends could hear the bell, but as years passed, it fell silent for all of them. Even Sarah found one Christmas, she could no longer hear its sweet sound. Though I have grown old, the bell still rings for me, as it does for all who truly believe. And that's most of you. And I think we have a special guest here tonight who's coming somewhere. Oh, listen. Listen. A special guest just to see you. Oh, my goodness, look.
Santa Claus is coming to town. 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 Santa Claus merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay.
Make the Yuletide gay.
From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Fates allow.